To me, it's the most famous and important home run ever hit in Major League Baseball. And the guy that caught it joins us now on MLB Tonight. Tom House, who pitched 12 years in the big leagues before founding the National Pitching Association and earning the nickname, quote, the father of modern pitching mechanics, was a teammate of Hank's in the bullpen that night behind the left field wall and caught that home run and immediately returned it to him. So, Dr. Tom House, thank you for joining us. Give me the play-by-play of that moment, like 10 seconds before the pitch. Where are you? Who you sit next to? What was going on behind that outfield wall?
Well, I was sitting there in my little territory. The bullpen guys had all agreed you get this 10-yard space and it belongs to you. And the count ran to where I was thinking maybe a fastball away is what Downing would throw, and that's what he threw. And whack, here comes the ball. Everybody talks about what a great play it was. If I would have stood still, it would have hit me in the forehead. So there's nothing magic about that. But I can remember Buckner trying, jump on the fence, saying, give it to me. And then a big fishnet went behind me. And the next thing I remember, I'm at home plate giving it to Henry. So that was the night, basically the highlight of my major league career. That's the good news and the bad news. So pretty special night.
12 years, Tom, and you're known as the guy who brought the ball to Hank. It's so fascinating. There's so much more. There were people running out on the field. So how did you get to him at home plate?
Well, we had it structured. The bullpen gate was right down the left field line, right underneath the foul pole. So we knew how to get out. And I remember catching the ball, yes, and then nothing. I can't tell you anything that happened between the time I caught the ball and the time I gave it to him at home plate. Literally, it was kind of a foggy blank.
So you guys were planning this. Did you have like odds on who might get it? And were you betting on this deal? What did you guys do in the bullpen about this?
If I'd been smart, I would have put some odds on it, whatever. But what we had done leading into the season, we started the season in Cincinnati, and Henry actually hit a home run, and I think his second AB off of Jack Billingham. And then there was a big question: does he play Saturday and Sunday? What if he hits a home run? Do we want him to hit it at home in Atlanta? So everybody had kind of played out all the scenarios. The one thing that the bullpen did do was we drew straws for territory, and then we all agreed to respect those territories. So again, the only guy that was further towards center field than myself was Buzz Capra. He and I were kind of low men on the totem pole. But I happen to be at the right place at the right time with the right sequence of events. Kind of a Forrest Gump movement.
Great line. Tom, it's Tom Verducci. I'm curious, this was the first home game for the Braves in 1974, so obviously you have a whole season ahead of you. After that night, that Monday night, did you get a sense how much the pressure was off Hank? And going a little more forward, was he disappointed that he wasn't considered as the Braves' next manager, because that job did open up, as you know?
Well, there were a lot of dynamics that were going on that I wasn't aware of. At that time, Dusty Baker and Ralph Garr were my battle buddies. We went through the minor leagues together. So I was hearing some of the stuff, but not all of it. And I actually feel that the home run kind of let all the pressure off Henry's back leading into it. Henry was the same guy no matter what. No matter what amount of chaos was going around in his environment, he would show up, Mr. Professional, quietly competent, do his job. He treated everybody the same, whether you're playing, hearts or spades with him in the middle of the clubhouse or was out in the middle of the diamond. Henry was Henry. And in retrospect, looking at him as a superstar, he's probably the most low-key superstar of anybody I've been around in either baseball, football, or golf. Pretty special man.
Tom, it's a perfect moment to watch him take that swing. It goes over the left field wall, including your catch. Did you ever think to yourself, man, what would have happened if I would have dropped that? I would have clinked it.
Obviously, and Harold, you played, if you sit there thinking, God, if I wonder what happens if I'm going to miss this ball, you'll miss it. What you learn to do as an athlete is realize if you think you can or you think you can't. So you either go blank, which is what I think I did, or you want the ball hit to you, and you just did what you've done your whole life. I probably caught at that point in time 50,000 fly balls, so it never occurred to me that I could miss it. I hope that made sense.
Yeah, that better makes sense. You made it work, put it that way. So, you know, you pitched for a number of years as well. So I'm going to ask you a two-part question because I don't know if you ever faced Hank, maybe in spring training or maybe in a game. That's one part of it. And the other part was, how do you think guys should have got him out? How would you pitch to him?
Well, to answer the first question, I had thrown a lot of batting practice to Henry. When he was having trouble with a pitch or a left-hand or right-hand or something, it would always, you know, Henry, Tom House, you and Henry go to Diamond Six for some extra hitting. So I'd probably thrown over the 5 or 6 years of major league camps, I'd probably thrown 10 or 11 batting practice sessions to him. But I only faced him one time when I was traded to the Red Sox and he was with Milwaukee. He came up with a man on second base and one out, and I pitched around him. And,
smart man.
Because open base, and they brought in a right-hander to get, I forget who hit after Henry. So the 1AB was very non-confrontational.
Tom House, thank you so much for this. The man that caught home run 715. We appreciate your time. Thank you again.
Thanks again, guys. Appreciate you also. Have a blessed day.